Hi everyone, welcome to our new attendance demo. Today, we'll be going through our new attendance experience in My Music Staff. This was a highly requested upgrade, so we're so excited to be able to finally share it with you. Now, I do want to mention just before we begin that for now, this is a totally optional upgrade, but we do hope that you love it as much as we do. So, to start things off, let me show you where you can turn this feature on or off. Once you're logged into your My Music Staff account, click on your name in the top right corner and then click on My Preferences. Open up the Attendance Preferences section by clicking on the pencil icon, and you'll see these two new options for interface version: New Attendance Experience, which is the new attendance upgrade, and Classic Attendance Experience, which is the old version. So let's go ahead and select New Attendance Experience so that we can jump in and look at all the new changes. Now, most of you are probably taking attendance for an individual student from the home agenda, so we'll start by looking at that, and then I can show you some of the other variations. When you click on Take Attendance, you'll get this window that slides out from the right. This is your new attendance page. To pick your student's attendance status, you can pick the appropriate one from the dropdown. Now, these are all the same options as the previous version of attendance. They're just laid out vertically instead of horizontally, and we've streamlined the information, so it's all right there in the dropdown. You can still change the lesson price and add a payment when the student is present, but most of these options will be one click and you're done. For lesson notes, you can go to the second tab, and it's identical to the previous lesson notes page, except that the templates button is now down at the bottom left. And now you can easily switch back and forth between student, parent, and private notes. When you scroll down, you'll see that we've updated the repertoire section as well. Now, all of your past lesson notes are here in the History tab, and this will actually show you not only your previous lesson notes, but also any previous repertoire assignments and practice log entries. When you're all set, you can click Save, and your attendance has been saved. Now, taking attendance from the calendar will be the exact same experience with that same window that's showing up. As you can see, this is very similar to the old attendance method, but we've tightened everything up to make it a lot quicker. Of course, where things generally tend to slow down is when you want to take attendance for multiple students at once. So that might be because you're taking attendance for a group lesson, or you're taking attendance for the whole day. Whatever the reason, we want to make sure that these processes work quicker as well. So we've actually created two different options for taking attendance for a group lesson, so you can use whichever method is going to work best for you. The first method is what we call Express Attendance. And that'll bring up the same attendance window that we were just looking at before, but as you can see at the bottom left here, there are arrows showing 1 of 5. This just means that all 5 students in this group lesson have their attendance windows open, and you can just scroll through each of them and take attendance all in one go. The other option is a new page that we call Bulk Attendance. When we click on this, we get brought to a new page that shows everyone from that lesson all in one list. So here you can manually select all their attendance statuses right away, or you can select the checkboxes next to their name and change a group of them, or select all and select all, set all of them to the same status. Clicking on the pencil on the right will bring that original attendance page back up for that student if you wanted to get into their details or take individual lesson notes. For group lesson notes though, you can click on this icon right here that looks like a piece of paper with a plus on it and take notes for this whole group lesson in one go. Now, this page isn't just good for group lessons. You can actually change these filters to span specific days, specific times, teachers, or filter by unrecorded. That way, if you need to do a ton of attendance all in one go, you can do so here. Now, there are 3 different ways to access this page, which is perfect for when you need to take attendance for multiple students at once. You can take attendance for a group lesson, so just like we just did, we took attendance for a group lesson and came to this page. Or if you're in the calendar, you can mark attendance for the entire day from the calendar. Or if you're in the home agenda, you can go to options and then set all unrecorded attendance, and that's going to bring you to this page as well. I guarantee that whatever way you were taking attendance before, there's a method that's going to work for you in this new version. We are so excited to be able to offer this new faster, more convenient, and more powerful upgrade to the attendance experience, and can't wait to get you all on board. As always, if you have any questions about this new update, our amazing support staff is always happy to hear from you and can help you out with anything you might need. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy the new attendance.